For today's video, we're gonna follow the gradual process of me turning into a caveman. But before we get into that, we're gonna upgrade the Samsung all-in-one. Now today's video is gonna be more like an interim max performance mod, because in typical Dawid fashion, some things went wrong that I didn't quite anticipate. So while we wait for some more adapters to show up from faraway lands, we're just gonna do the max performance we can get out of the closed unit, because the one that we have standing here is significantly more powerful than the stock version. So with that, let's rip it open and follow the upgrade process, and then we'll compare pre-caveman to post-caveman gaming performance. Now the first step is to use the little memory glory hole on the back to upgrade the RAM. We're gonna go from a 2 and a 4 gig stick to 2 8 gig sticks, giving us 10 gigs more RAM. Wow, it's amazing how much easier it is to get the back off once you've popped the virginity. Now while I'm under here, I'm also gonna swap the hard drive out for an SSD, because that's gonna be way faster. I'm gonna use this old Samsung 840 Evo, which is actually the first SSD I ever bought, and it still works perfectly. The next step is replacing the CPU, going from a 3470T to a 3770, which not only has 4 more threads running at a much faster speed, but it also replaces that terrible iGPU in the 3470T with something slightly less terrible. Weirdly, the 3770 that I bought off eBay was actually vandalized. Somebody scratched a bunch of gusta into it. I don't know if I should be impressed by the precision or outraged by the vandalism. Okay, so I'm gonna put the cooler back on. I'm not entirely convinced that this cooling system is gonna be able to handle the 3770, but we'll see how it goes, you know? This is experimentation. I'm sure we can figure something out if it doesn't. Okay, let's see if it works with the new CPU and the new SSD. Hey, okay, so we just need to install Windows on here again, but it works. So the CPU that's been vandalized has not been killed, at least. So with that, I'm gonna install Windows on it. So this is running with the upgraded setup. We're practicing with bots, so bear that in mind. But the performance already feels way better. It's at the same settings and, you know, it's still not something I'd use to play against other people with, but it's not bad. One thing that is clear though is that we've got a much bigger thermal load on the cooling solution. We have about 74 degrees Celsius on the CPU, but it's still boosting to about 3.8 gigahertz. So that's not bad. I think the benchmarks are going to be way better. So let's see how it compares. After all of that, we doubled our gaming performance, taking it from completely unplayable to just plain terrible, which is, you know, that's a little bit better, I guess. I didn't have more gaming benchmarks because, well, quite frankly, the stock configuration can't really play many games well enough to get a reasonable benchmarking result. So that's why we only had these three games. Looking at GTA running side by side on the two configurations, you can see that 100% performance uplift in all its glory. Although with the max performance mod, we're still struggling to get 24 frames per second. And bear in mind that that's at 720p. So yeah, that's pretty horrendous. Another interesting thing to look at is the temperatures. We're getting about 80 degrees Celsius with that 3770. And that's with a CPU utilization of about 25%. That means if we do ever get like an external GPU going and that CPU utilization increases, it's gonna get hotter than a Taco Bell toilet run real fast. Although when it comes to Cinebench R20, the temperatures were in the low 80s, which isn't too bad. And obviously the score is significantly higher than the previous version. And then finally, the reason that we don't have the max performance upgrade is because Dawid was a bit of a dum-dum and bought the wrong adapters and stuff. So if you look on the back of the all-in-one's motherboard, you'll see that there's a Wi-Fi card that uses what looks at a glance like an M.2 slot. So I bought this awesome looking adapter, which is really cool. It's like an M.2 to PCI Express adapter that actually has supplemental power for the graphics card and stuff. I'm pretty excited to use that. But the problem was, the moment that I removed the actual Wi-Fi card, I realized that it wasn't an M.2 slot, it was a mini PCIe slot. Which is good, it means it uses PCIe lanes, so it should be able to communicate with the graphics card, but it's not M.2. Now luckily, there are M.2 to PCIe mini adapters, and I bought one of those, but the one that I bought had to be modified to fit in, and once it fit in, the actual M.2 cable, well, that wouldn't fit because of the positioning of the connector on the motherboard. So I've now ordered like a ribbon cable adapter, which will probably work even though there is this space constraint, but it's gonna take ages to get here, so I'm just gonna wait for that. Now I know that using a mini PCIe to M.2 adapter to adapt a graphics card to work with the system is gonna be a bottleneck akin to shiving the graphics card in the balls, but that's okay. I'm just hopeful that it'll at least work. Hopefully we'll get better performance than the integrated graphics on the 3770. So with that, thank you very much for watching. If you like the sound of what is about to happen and is potentially gonna be a failure, like and subscribe to the channel for that video. And until the next video, bye-bye.